everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new here. My name is Stephy, and in today's video we are heading to Iceland. I am on a trip for 4 nights, 5 days with my boyfriend Shay. And we are going to take you along with us, so come on up.
When we wake, hear the birds and see the sun, side by side our fears are done. Oh, the good times just begun. Oh, we know what we have, let's hold on tight.
It's cold, it's bitter, it's -1. It's not bad.
It's, I just that's need terrible thermals. At the moment. Yeah. At the moment it's okay. It's fine, cold, yeah. But it's not.
Call us crazy, but things are finally right. With you and I, the future is bright.
Hi everyone, we have made it to the hotel. We are staying in Sand Hotel. We've just checked in. We had to get off the coach and basically had to walk from a bus stop because coaches can't come up certain roads and everything. So that was interesting. I did trip, but I tripped over the pavement because it was a bit cobbly. Anyway.
It was very icy everywhere.
And it was icy as well, yeah. So being in Iceland, but it's so nice here. We landed safely. It was literally under 3 hours flight, wasn't it? Which was amazing. I think it was meant to be 3 hours, 40 minutes or something. The time difference thing is the exact same. So it's the exact same time in the UK. Everything was fine as well, getting through security. Yeah, it was fine. Obviously, it was, yeah, it was a very quick process and everything. It is cold. It is currently -1 degrees. Well, when we landed, it was -1 degrees.
It's cold, but it's not,
but it's bearable, it's isn't bearable it? Everywhere. Yeah. And we didn't know if the Northern Lights tour that we have included in our booking was on tonight because we were told it was cloudy, and we've just had a text message from our TUI rep because we booked our package with TUI, and they said it's on, so we're going to the Northern Lights tonight as well, which is exciting. However, I am on the hunt for either a hot dog or fish and chips when we do get sorted though. I'm very excited, so we're gonna sort ourselves out and I will see you in a bit. Hello, we napped. I think we only napped for probably not even an hour, to be honest. And I'm gonna do a room tour quickly now that we've unpacked. I've just freshened up. This is the door. And then you have the wardrobe area, very nice. And then a little kind of seating area. Shane's over there, he's very dopey still. Spare towel, oh no, the dressing gowns.
Yes.
I think radio or little tea facility. This is the safe and fridge, can't talk. just areas, TV, some artwork. This is the bed, as you can see, we've slept in. This is the area, as you can see, it's snow. It's very bright still. It is currently 4:25, and I thought it would be a lot darker. And then this is the bathroom, which is rather nice, very bright, very big shower. We're gonna head out to Reykjavik. I think that's how you pronounce it, and if it is, I'm very, very impressed. Because we are literally in the center, in the heart of Reykjavik, which is all good. We want to go find the church. I can't remember the name, probably won't even be able to pronounce it, so I'm not even going to try. And we are hungry, we haven't eaten pretty much. And then we've got the Northern Lights tour booked tonight, so it's gonna be a long night. It's gonna be a long night, but we are all good. Just packed all my bits. Oh, so let's go adventure Reykjavik. So this is the hotel, this is the Sound Hotel that we're staying in. Automatic door. Very nice. This is the bakery next door.
Oh
my bad. Oh, that group of like kids, bless them. You heard them, I'm sure you heard them. Oh my god, there's donuts. I'm getting donuts.
No, we need food, real food first.
Okay, but I really want donuts. Oh, it's a bit windy. That's a bit cold. My hands are cold now.
It's not too bad.
Oh no.
It's not too bad.
It isn't. Do you know what? It's not as cold as I thought it was going to be. Seeing like -1, I thought it was going to be absolutely freezing, but it isn't. It literally isn't, so look at this!
What?
Because we're right by the harbour, but we are walking to, well no, we're walking to the harbour, but it is the harbour. We're right by the sea, it is. My nose is running, everything's happening. Oh, my face is so cold, it really is. Everything else is fine, it's just my face is cold.
Right, I think we're going to this place, Segrifin, I think that's what it's called, because there is lobster tea, so I don't know if we're going to try this or not, and grilled fish.
Hello, so we're inside, we have just ordered. We are getting a portion of the lobster soup. Stay tuned to find out if Moonshine likes it. And also, we have gone for grilled fish, and it's basically it's white fish. Oh wow, it's come out so quick. This is soup.
I have put an extra spoon here.
Oh, thank you very much, cheers.
So this is,
where are we?
This thing.
We also got one of these, which I think is like a Fanta.
Sorry.
Nice.
I think so.
At least it's going to warm us up, which would be good. I am nervous though.
Mm.
Yeah? It smells good. Yeah.
Oh, I'm scared.
It's not fishy.
It's not. It's not fishy at all.
You can't really taste it with the bread, can you?
Not really, no. I think there might be like bits of lobster maybe down below. It's not bad.
Yeah. Sure. You're not going to like that.
Yeah, I wouldn't really prefer
that. It's the... It just tastes like the soup. But, it's... You're not going to like that texture. I promise you.
Do you like it?
Not the texture, no.
Okay, so the grilled tusk.
I'm just going to put a bit of lemon on them. We've also got a chilli mayonnaise. I'll just pull it off.
Is it really good?
Yeah, you're gonna like that.
Okay.
You just stuck it into it.
Yeah, of course I am. Ready. Oh my god.
Nice.
Oh god, that's so good. Oh. This isn't bad. I do prefer Fanta.
You do?
Mm.
Yeah.
So in total, in the UK wise, because we haven't got any Icelandic money, I'm just paying with my bank card. And it cost £24.26 altogether. So I kind of drink grilled tusk and a portion of lobster soup, which I don't think is too bad. The grilled tusk, white fish, basically is in like the cod and haddock kind of family. It was so good, so good. Could have eaten about three of them, couldn't we, Jane? So good. The lobster soup, on the other hand, which I know is an Icelandic delicacy, personally I didn't like. But I that's my first time ever trying lobster. I don't really Yeah, what did you think?
I just think it was okay.
Yeah, it didn't really taste of anything. There wasn't really a taste.
Doesn't have really a taste. And yeah. It was very soggy in the soup. The soup was nice, but that's about it. It was just nice. Yeah. It's nothing like, yeah, man, let's get some lobster soup. Yeah,
and the thing is as well, is that I was a bit too worried to try the lobster instead. I couldn't. It was the texture that was really kind of like cringing me out because of how... Yeah. So fish and chips was good, very good. Now heading to Cafe Loki and we are going to have the rye bread ice cream. Hello, so we are in Cafe Loki. What we just ordered came to £21 something. So we got a hot chocolate with cream for me. What did you get?
A
white chocolate mocha for Shane. And then we also ordered, let me show you,
Loki's rye bread ice cream with cream and rhubarb syrup. What did you get?
The sky cake.
Oh, this one?
Yeah.
With sky cake with
rhubarb syrup.
Cream.
Yeah.
That is so good.
Does it taste like cookies and cream?
It tastes like cookies and cream. It's so good.
That's good.
I can eat so many of them. That rye bread ice cream.
Yeah.
And the bowl is so cold to keep it cold. Just got that all over my finger. So good. Hot chocolate, very nice. So we are currently on our way to bus stop 6, which is the one that we got off at anyway for our hotel situation earlier, because we are going on the Northern Lights tour. And Shane has just checked for literally like a good 10-20 minutes probably straight to see what the kind of like clear sky, like there is no cloud in the sky, the moon is up there. Oh wow, look at the church behind. Hopefully we get to see them tonight, that'd be nice. If not, it does get rebooked, which is good. Very exciting, the sky is clear. I can't really see many stars, I'll be honest, so yeah. But we are currently waiting for the Northern Lights. It's 10 o'clock. It's 10 o'clock, it's, I think it's a -3 on the coach or something. I don't know if we're gonna see them. I feel like we have a high chance, but I just feel like there's a lot of light around. Like, whether it's coaches or... There is a lot of light around. We need to... Oh my god.
Yeah, it's -3.
Oh my god, we're on ice. I want to move. We're in the snow area and it's quite deep, so we keep like... we keep like sinking. And it's, oh my god. It's so funny. But yeah, you can't really see me as well. Hopefully, we'll be able to see the Northern Lights, but we will see. We will see. Hello everyone. Oh god, what a state. We have just got back to the hotel room. Northern Lights. we was waiting around for about 1 hour and 20 and then we saw kind of like a green light It was very faint, and we was like, okay, we got some pictures. It was literally just kind of like a line. It wasn't like as pretty and like dancey as like the Northern Lights is. We knew, you know, it may or may not happen, so we was aware of that anyway. We're not, you know, it's not guaranteed. And then we waited, I think, an extra 10-20 minutes, and then it came up a little bit brighter, so we was able to get better pictures. However, the pictures are literally just this. It wasn't as like vibrant as certain people's pictures are, whether they're edited or whether, you know, there is photographers with specific lenses. I'm not trying to, you know, Debbie Downer or anything by any means, but I just feel like seeing them like that, and this was a medium kind of rate to see them as well, so like I can't imagine what like the low is. I'm glad I've seen them with my eyes, but I just feel like they just really weren't as bright, and I use the nighttime mode on my iPhone 11 Pro. I just feel like you kind of get the best pictures when you have really good camera qualities. On the vlogging camera, it didn't show up. I was so cold. It was -4 and -5 at one point. However, these hand heaters were amazing, but I completely forgot about them until we got back on the coach. So now they're all nice and warm. We have got the Golden Circle tour tomorrow. We are absolutely exhausted. It is literally 10 to 1. It's 10 to 1 and we've got to be up at like 7 tomorrow. We've got our tour at 8:30. Wish the tour tomorrow was later. So I'm ending today's part and I will see you tomorrow. Bye. Good morning, everyone. It is 8:40. We have just had breakfast very quickly. I will show you it all tomorrow because we was in a bit of a rush this morning because obviously how late we got back yesterday. But it's snowing. It's snowing. My face is getting wet. It's snowing. It's so pretty. Ah, very, very nice. So we are heading to bus stop 6, which is where our Golden Circle tour coach is picking us up at. Currently -6 degrees. I think I'm adapting. So much snow everywhere. Oh. Hello. That was a very long trip.
Hour and 40 minutes
yeah. In the coach.
Sauna coach.
Yeah, it's very warm in the coach, which is good though. We are now at the Geysir Center. Off to go find some geysers, apparently. So many people say geysers though. It's definitely Geysir, isn't it? I don't know. If you're from the UK, Geysir just sounds so much... It's just something else, doesn't it? I cannot believe how like bright it is. Oh, so bright. Just taking a walk up to, I think, where the bigger ones are. These are really nice, don't get me wrong, but there's like a main area and it's a lot bigger. Well, it's a bit icy. Where are you?
Good.
It's not bad. It's -8, -7, -8.
There's no wind though.
There isn't any wind.
It's not windy, so.
If this was like it yesterday,
we would be.
Even at this temperature, dead. I would have been, yeah. We are at the next stop now, which is Gullfoss Waterfall. We've just had food. We had the lamb soup. I enjoyed it. Shane did not. And a chocolate cake. Yeah. To be fair though, I don't know. It wasn't fatty or anything. Whereas lamb normally is. I couldn't really film because it was like tables with all buses and everything. I felt a bit awkward and a bit cramped just to whip my camera out in front of everyone. But we are now going to hunt for the waterfall. Very excited. Very, very excited. And we just got Shane's nephew a little present as well. We'll show you that later on. It's very cute. Not bad price, but we're just having to currency convert everything. 900 or 600 and something, and we have no idea what that means, so.
I'm eating tonight.
Hello everyone, I had a lovely nap on the coach. Oh, I felt so sick, travel sick, but yeah. I never normally get travel sick, but I do feel a bit rough. It's snowing. I don't know how much I'm going to be able to vlog here because obviously my camera and the snow. But we are now at the last stop, which I think you pronounce Pingvellir, the national park. This is where there's all like rifts, apparently, they said, which is basically... What is it, like the crate? Is it the crater? I can't remember. But there's all like gaps, so if we don't stay on the path, we'll probably fall and get lost, which is not good. Right, so I just had to put you away because there is so many icy stairs. I've just slid down, like, on my butt, but willingly. And it was fun. I'm not gonna lie, it was quite fun. Shane is just, oh my god, skidding in his element. Which is why I put you guys away, because there was no way I was, like, sacrificing my camera. So, oh my god. Yeah. It's just really snowing. It's very pretty though. It's like a winter wonderland. Hello, we are back in the hotel room now. We are knackered. It is currently, what time is it? 4:20. Oh god, I'm just sinking into the bed. We're so tired, aren't we?
Struggling. It's going to be hard not to have a nap now, but I don't want to nap.
Yeah, well, I napped on the coach for however long.
And I also got a picture of you.
Oh no, did you?
Yeah, look.
Oh no, that's so bad. Hang on. That's really zoomed up. Good camera though. So we are just planning our lives. We're not necessarily hungry as of yet, but I do want to try the best hot dog in the world, apparently, which is the Icelandic hot dog, because we have nothing planned for tomorrow. On Saturday we have a volcano tour, black sand beach and the Blue Lagoon. So we are just deciding what we are going to do tomorrow, and then we'll probably just chill, catch our breath, and then head back out into Reykjavik, which would be good, just to find something. I think you want a burger, don't you? And
possibly,
I want to try a hot dog. I really want to try the hot dog. Oh wait, let me show you the shoes that we picked up from the, where did we go, the waterfall. It's
Gullfoss.
Look at them, how cute. We got them in size 6 to 18 months. They were 9.90 krona, Icelandic krona, I think. Oh my god, adorable. And that came to £7.7p altogether. Yeah.
They're very rather cute.
They are adorable. And we had to get the puffin ones because obviously puffins are an Icelandic thing. So yeah, very cute. very, very cute. So we finally decided what we're doing tomorrow. Shane found a lava caving small group adventure. It's 3 hours long. It does include a transfer though, so the caving will not be 3 hours, which we've learned from today that, you know, the majority of the tour is kind of travel, which is fair enough. It cost £67 per person, and we booked that with Get Your Guide, and I will link it down below if you do want to do the exact same tour, and also I will link Saturday's tour down below as well.
Let's go.
I'm so grouchy because I'm tired, I feel sick still, and I'm hungry.
And this is Stephanie, that she has it with no toppings.
I had it with the ketchup though.
Ooh, adventurous.
It's a hot dog.
Is it a hot dog, yeah?
I like it.
Of course you do, it's a hot dog.
It's a hot dog, but you are meant to have it with all of it on.
So why?
But obviously I didn't. Because one, I don't like mustard. Two, I don't like mayo. Three, I don't like onions, and there's like two kinds of onions.
This is what it's meant to look like with all of it on.
I'm getting the lamb, and you don't normally get that in a hot dog, obviously. It's okay.
Do you think it's the best hot dog in the world?
Good. It's okay, it's nice.
So, that cost UK money £3.27. I would happily pay that. I enjoyed it, it's filled me up for a little bit, but definitely gonna be on the hunt for more food. I'm not sure 100% what the plan is as of yet. I'm glad we've tried it. It's nice. I think that was kind of everything on our bucket list as well, like food wise to try, but it was nice. It was a little hut just there. Realistically, compared to the UK hot dog wieners that we have, that was 10 times nicer.
You think?
Yeah. Do you know what? I would happily
eat that.
You like
lamb, don't you?
Well,
I'm
yeah.
getting just like struck, and you can really taste the lamb in that.
Yeah, it definitely isn't porky.
Porky.
Hello, we're in a, what is it called? Yuzu.
Yuzu, yeah.
Yuzu. It's a bit crowded though, so if I just whip my camera up in front of everyone. We have just spent, I think mine's £18 altogether. I think Shane's is £25 for, he gets a burger, chips and a sauce and a rice beer, and I got a pink lemonade, which is quite fancy, fried chicken strips and chips with a sauce, but Shane is just to try this rice beer. Luckily it was a pint.
It's not quite to the top though.
No.
Had a bit of a swig.
It's quite nice.
Is it?
Yeah. Try it, just for the lols.
I don't drink beer.
Steph does not drink beer at all.
It smells like beer.
I mean, that looks so weird in your hand. That doesn't like you. Just you just.
Oh,
imagine
if I was a lager drinker.
No, not at all.
No.
Beer is disgusting. Beer is literally vile. It's not bad. Out of the UK beers I've tried, that's probably the nicest, the Icelandic one.
Would I count?
Yeah, it was £8.27 for. There is quite a lot of people around, so I don't want just want to boop. But it's very cool and quirky in here. Very cool. Quite like American. Good morning everyone, we forgot to end the vlog last night. We came back to the hotel and we was FaceTiming our families, so sorry. But today it is currently 8:10, we're just about to go down for breakfast and then walk to the bus stop for the lava tunnel tour today, which is very, very exciting. We're here, we made it. Oh wow, look. Ta-da. We're about to go through the tunnel in pitch black, like all the lights off.
She's going to turn the lights off.
She's going to turn the lights off, so it's going to be pitch black.
Three, two, one.
Oh my god.
Wow.
You ready? Here we are. Do we have everyone? So this is the only thing that lives down here. What this is actually just bacteria. And they make it quite nice. It's called cave bacteria. Made it painfully easy, I'm really happy about that.
Oh my god. It's quite narrow. What's up, that stuff?
Lovely. That was amazing.
That was smashing, wasn't it?
That was so cool. So cool. Oh, it's a lot colder up here. Hello, hello. We have just got off. It is almost 12. Near on 12 o'clock, I think.
Hang on.
There you go. Hang on, 12 o'clock. So that was really fun. I enjoyed the tour. Did you?
Yeah, it's my favourite thing so far.
Yeah, it was amazing. Really enjoyed it. Really good. Really good tour. It was really fun. Highly recommend. It was £68, just over £68 per person.
I'd
but
recommend
with transport.
Doing longer as well.
Yeah. If you can. Wow, that's gold. That's breezy and cold. If you can do longer and can afford to do longer because it is a bit more, then obviously do. But if you can't, then that one isn't bad at all. It's very, very good. So really liked it. I want to hunt for a magnet and a postcard. Little souvenirs. Just want to get a picture of the flag actually. And then we're just gonna mooch around. And then Shane has just booked us to do this museum thing. We'll explain all when we're there. Again, I'll link that down below. And if you are interested, I'll link the
Perlan.
The tunnel. A cave tunnel that we just did down below as well, just in case you want to, you know, book it or anything. But look at the flag. I just bought some Icelandic chocolate, but this is, oh my god, milk chocolate creaming with salted caramel.
That sounds good.
That sounds so good.
What's that, like £3-4, something like that?
It was like £3.49.
£3.49.
Oh my god, there is so much caramel coming out. Oh wow, it smells good. Oh my god, that is so good. Well, we're not in the hotel room, we're in the hotel lobby. And we just picked up Vinberid, the truffles. You open them.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so nice.
Oh, wow.
Oh, they look good. So mine ones were sea salt. The blue one, which looks very pretty, sea salt. White chocolate truffle is the white one.
That's white and rose, though.
White and rose, yeah. And vanilla, and it's vanilla as well, I think.
Yeah, and then that one
is apple and cinnamon.
And then I got pistachio. Oh, it was the passion fruit one. What? And hazelnut.
Should we give them a go? Yeah. What one do we go for first? Go for the apple one first.
That.
Not for you, no. Okay, the apple and cinnamon. Not for us.
Pistachio.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Good?
Uh-huh. I would pay £10.50 for six of those.
Yeah. Mm.
That's amazing.
The white.
The white and rose one.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I'm gonna like this one.
That tastes like perfume and elderflower.
Yeah, and I knew exactly that would taste like that. I don't know why you picked it.
It's okay. It's a bit, tastes a bit perfumey. It's elderflower.
So all three of the ones that I chose, it was the server's favourite as well. So the passion fruit, the hazelnut and the pistachios.
So the ones I've chosen so far are not the best.
That smells like perfume, yeah.
But get past the perfume and really keep going. Elderflower.
Mm. Oh.
Yeah, get past that.
It's like Turkish delight.
It is, that's exactly what it's like. Mm. Yeah, hazelnut. That's gotta be good. You know what you're getting with that.
So hazelnut.
Hazelnut? It's hazelnut.
That one was really good. We're going for the passion fruit, which was my last one. Wow.
Really?
Wow. I paid £10.50 for that. I didn't need a lot in there, so I knew you wouldn't. I love passion fruit. That is a bit me. All three of them I loved. All three. Again, I would get six.
It's okay.
It's very sweet.
Oh no.
Sea salt something. Why is it blue? The texture. What's on the inside? Show the inside. That looks like an egg.
Oh, hang on.
What is it? I don't know how fuzzy it is.
I've forgotten what it tastes like already. It tastes fruity but sweet.
Oh, pepper.
As well?
Hairy.
What is that?
I don't like the outside.
There's a nice bit, isn't there? And then there's a horrible bit.
It's fruity, it's like citrus.
Yeah.
The blue on the outside isn't needed.
It's like a coconut texture.
It's sea salt and it's that's white chocolate.
Oh, well, there you go.
Right, verdict. The worst one was the apple cinnamon.
Definitely.
Second worst was that blue one.
Really?
For me, yeah. Only because I really like the others. I would then go the rose one, like the Turkish delight rose one, then hazelnut, then the mango, and then pistachio.
I think the worst for me was the apple and cinnamon, then the passion fruit, then the elderflower.
The rose one.
Rose
yeah.
one.
Then you had then hazelnut, pistachio, and
then
the blue
that blue one.
One.
Then pistachio. Pistachio?
Pistachio is the green one.
Yeah. And the hazelnut was the best one.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, see, I thought pistachio was the best one.
Yeah.
So this is my little postcard that I picked up. This was 75p. Lovely. It's a nice little postcard. And then I also picked up this magnet, which is quite cool. This was 790 ISK or KR. Which I think is probably about £3, £2 something. And then these are the Om Nom chocolates. So we've got two of the sea salted almonds, caramel, cookies and cream, and sea salted toffee. This was £20, £20 something. Charging batteries, sprucing up, all that jazz, and then we are gonna figure out how to get to a bus stop to then go to the museum exhibition thing, and that's going to be our activity for this evening. Okay, so we just got the bus and it's the most confusing thing ever because the only way to buy tickets is cash or to download an app. The bus driver didn't know the name of the app, which was always very, very helpful. And it wasn't working, so we couldn't actually purchase the tickets, and the guy was running late, so he just let us on, which was great. But when we do get off at the bus stop, it's right near the motorway, pretty much the main road, and it's scary because they're going like 60-70 miles an hour. But walk around the corner and we're here. So we are at the Perlan Museum Exhibition, Wonders of Iceland.
notice Stephanie's feet can't touch the ground.
Do you know, this isn't bad.
It's not that cold, is
minus
it?
Minus 15.
Wim Hof
in Iceland.
Hang on.
Oh, that's terrifying.
Yeah,
that. One, oh, well, that's someone getting beheaded. That's
we're
someone
gonna
getting.
Die.
That's
we're gonna die. We're gonna die.
Oh, please don't shot. Please don't shot. Please don't shot.
Oh my god.
Anxiety with that. That was
horrible. Oh my god. That was alright. That was nice. That was cute.
The Northern Lights store was colder.
Yeah, oh my god, the proper Northern Lights store. We also did go in to the Northern Lights kind of like theatre show, but we couldn't film it, so we did just do that. Oh, and now we're up here with all the glaciers. Cool. Decided to vlog at the worst time because we're right by the main road. We're currently in the bus stop waiting for bus number 18. It's literally completely opposite. We was able to download the app. It is a different app. We asked the receptionist at the Perlan, and it's so much easier. The app is called Clap, K-L-A-P-P. It cost $9.80-ish, which is... For two people, bus ticket costs £5.85. Amazing, two adults. You scan the barcodes when you get on the bus. It's literally two stops to Reykjavik bus station, which is all good. The Perlan was great. It was, how much was it? £26 something per person. Well, the one that we went for, we got the dome experience included as well. You don't have to pay for that if you don't want to, but we decided we did. We couldn't film in it, but it was basically about the Northern Lights, which was really cool. So yeah, we are just chilling, killing, waiting for the bus. And then we are gonna go find some food.
Hello, so we are in Himalayan Spice, right next door to where we had the lobster soup and the tusk. A couple of days ago, the first day, we have just ordered the collard beverage.
Shame there's a Viking beer.
Slightly cheaper than the
just a little bit cheaper.
Beer, £7 something.
I think like a vodka on its own is like £6 something. I don't know if you have to pay extra for the mixer. If the mixer is, then it has probably come to £10. But I've gone for lamb chops, which I'm very excited about. And Shane's got this like platter with like curry.
Spice platter or something. I've got something. We'll show you.
Yeah. It's so cozy in there. Yeah.
Nice little spot we're in. Mm-hmm. Nice car as well. It's a nice little table.
Yeah. Very cozy.
Pasta. I like the flag. Yeah, it's really nice. Hello. So that meal was incredible. Oh, I always start filming when we're on the main road.
Tell them about the lamb.
Oh my god, the lamb chops was incredible, absolutely incredible. But for a vodka and coke and that lamb chops, it cost me £33, which I don't think it's bad. I would absolutely happily pay £24, whatever it was, for that lamb chop again. So good, so good. Shane, did you enjoy your meal?
It was really nice.
Yeah. Really, really good. Yeah. Really good. Highly recommend that place.
I would. See, I'm not a massive lamb fan.
Yeah.
But those lamb chops were amazing.
Oh my god, it was amazing. There was three of them, and they were so. Oh my god, the seasoning was just amazing. The chef came out and he was like, "How's your meal?" And honestly, it was just incredible. It was so, so nice. Seasoning, absolutely amazing. The flavour, I would 100% get that again.
We have made it back to the hotel. We was going to go for waffles, but I still feel really full, even from that walk. I am planning on posting loads on Instagram and, of course, my stories as well. So if you have only just clicked onto this video, you have no idea who I am. My name is Stephy. Nice to meet y'all. And I have been adding to a highlight on my Instagram. So please do check it out. It is literally at selflove with Stephy, my Instagram handle. And there is an Iceland highlight as well, so you can watch all of this trip so far as well, which is amazing. And obviously all the posts and everything that I do, of course, post. So please do check that out, of course. But we are cream crackered. We are up early. I am literally getting up at 6 tomorrow. We have got to go down for breakfast at 7, and then we are on a volcano tour, which is amazing. So we're going to the volcano, we're going to the black sand beach, and then ending with Blue Lagoon, which is amazing. I'm so, so excited. We haven't even done as much today, what it doesn't feel like, but that meal was just amazing. I can't get over it. Absolutely amazing. So I'm gonna end it here. See you in the morning. Oh, good morning everyone. It is our last full day. Well, it was our last day pretty much, because we fly back tomorrow morning. We are on our way to the bus stop for our volcano tour, black sand beach visit, and Blue Lagoon, which is why I'm very fresh faced and looking like this. It's minus 11 currently. The coldest it's been, literally the coldest it's been. But it's not bad. Yeah, it's minus 11. There's like hardly any snow on the floor. But yeah, definitely all the layers. I'm definitely made up quite a few rolls, got quite a few pastries from breakfast. I finally was able to film breakfast this morning. Every other morning we've been in a rush and it's been quite busy. So going down for like 7 a.m. this morning to do it was kind of like a prime time. There was people as well, so I was like discreetly trying to film it and everything. So many nice food. It's very Icelandic. You're not gonna get like your fried egg and bacon as such, which is good though. It's gonna be a very long day. Our tour starts at 8 and I think finishes at around 6. So we've got a 10-hour tour, obviously being on the coach and everything. Knackered. Absolutely knackered already. We are here. We are all in fancy orange vests because we have to with the group. The bus cannot go up this hill. So we are having to do an extra 15-20 minute walk to the volcano, to the area. It's gonna get steeper.
We've just been told where I can't even see them. Where these two people are, those two, is where we're going.
Oh my god. Oh god, it's so steep. Oh my god. And it's so deep. Oh my god, look how deep it is.
Very deep.
Oh, this is it. I hope this is it. So when you come to volcanoes, you cannot take any bit of lava with you away, but because this is new lava, we are allowed to. So we've just taken 3 chunks, 2 big ones and 1 little one. We can't go any further, so we can't go onto that bit because it is very hot. And the steam that you see is actually gas.
Wow, this is a lot steeper.
It's very steep, isn't it?
Oh my god. And because that wasn't enough, we're now walking up here.
Yeah.
Which is a lot.
Oh, I'm gonna go.
I think I am. I'm just gonna.
Yeah? The rocks really support you.
Oh my god! I don't think it does like this. We have just arrived finally at Blue Lagoon. Very, very excited. We get a drink with the standard and also a face mask, so we will find that at some point, but I just went for a fruit juice because yeah. And Shane went for a beer. There we go. Hello. It's very deep. I'm currently on my tiptoes. Trying to. It's so steamy.
It's very steamy.
It's really steamy. So we're trying to get pictures and it's just kind of not happening. It's very nice. Very, very nice. But yeah.
Just can't see a lot.
Just can't see a lot, yeah. Probably not. Okay, so we're all done. My hair is drenched. Oh god, my hair feels so dry. Obviously tried to insert as much footage as I could get. It was so steamy though, so steamy. Quite a few people that we know have said that the floor is slimy in the Blue Lagoon. Not one bit. Not slimy at all. So I don't know where they're getting that from. But we're just heading back to the coach now. It was amazing. It was so, so good. The face mask did sting a little bit, but my skin feels all soft now. It was so good. Did you enjoy it?
Sorry?
Did you enjoy it?
It was really nice, yeah.
It was really relaxing, wasn't it?
I could have done another hour in there, to be honest.
Yeah, I definitely could have done another hour. Would have liked to have eaten there as well, just to kind of experience what the food was like in there, because it smelt really good, so. So I wasn't filming. And I really wish I was, because it was brilliant. Shake, she's kidding. He's just skidded so much and just, well,
it's so slippery.
We are currently en route to grab a Domino's because why not? And their, oh my god, their menu looks amazing. There's like Cajun chicken.
I think we just can't be bothered for like another restaurant tonight.
Yeah, we're that tired and we've got a pack and everything tonight. Right, we're just gonna go enjoy this. Oh, that lighting is dreadful. Hello everyone, we have just got back and I am packing. That Domino's was very good.
very good. It cost £30 something altogether for two smalls and 10 deluxe wings. And then those breadstick things as well. I am just finishing off packing and everything. That is that, but there isn't going to be much more of this vlog, so I'm going to end it here. I hope you enjoyed this entire vlog and this trip of me and my boyfriend Shane. We have got two other holidays planned in probably less than a month. We have Amsterdam planned for end of March, so there will be a vlog of that as well. And then in May we are going to Santorini, which is in Greece, so we will be vlogging that as well. So if you've enjoyed this vlog and want to follow me on future travel vlog type of videos, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and click the bell, then you'll be notified for when I upload. And also check out my Instagram, which is at selflovewithstephy, and click on the Iceland highlight and you will literally see the entire stories that I've done, as well as all the posts and everything as well. But yeah, if you have enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Oh, what a great few days it has been. So without much further ado, we are going. Say goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.